Hi, and welcome back to Level 2 of Lesson 4. We'll continue on our trek towards using Excel to help us make educated, rule-based decisions. We talked previously about functions that return true or false values, like the OR, and the NOT functions, as well as various relational operators, like equal, less than, greater than, stuff like that. In this video, we'll build upon that work and begin our discussion of the IF functions, as well as what are referred to as nested functions. What we have here is a table with some customers' names and some related data like their type, their current credit balance, their 30, 60, and 90-day past due balances, and then the sum of all three of these columns. The last column here indicates whether or not the zone has approved them for credit. See here? These companies are approved, and these last two are not. If you're looking at this for the first time and didn't understand what had happened previously, just looking at the current credit status column might be confusing. It might not be clear to you what true or false means in a column that's labeled status. Is true good or is false good? Is true unapproved or in trouble? A better alternative to the Boolean values of true or false would be to use the words approved and not approved for true or false. That would make this information in this table much clearer. Let's set that up here in column I. Let's enter in a new header called Current Credit Status Detail, and then copy the format from this adjacent cell using the format painter that we learned about in a previous lesson. Now I'll introduce you to a new function. Class, meet the IF function. IF function, meet my awesome students. IF is a logical function that analyzes a Boolean condition, or a logical true-false condition, and returns one value if it's true, and another value if it's false. Let's start off our formula with equals IF, and then our parentheses. Look here in this function's signature. It first asks for a logical test. This must be a value that is either true or false. For this formula, let's just use this cell in the adjacent column, H3, since this is the value we want to transform into our text of approved and not approved. Follow that up with a comma. Now the signature shifts to the value if true part of the IF function. If this value in H3 is true, then we want the function to return or show the word approved wrapped in double quotes. Anytime we have a word or a chunk of text here, we must wrap it in these double quotes. If you have a number in here, there's no need to surround it in quotes. Let's end this part of the function with a comma, and the function's signature tells us that we are now in the value if false area of our if function. So if H3 is false, then we want the formula to instead display not approved, again wrapped in double quotes. The IF function always returns one of two values depending on whether the value being checked is either true or false. Another way of reading this that some people, typically people with programming experience, prefer is to read it as this. If this, then this. Else this. However you choose to think about it, it works the same way either way, so I'm going to close our parentheses and hit enter. We get the output of the function as approved. Let's drag it down and look at the other results down here. If this is true, then approved. If this is false, then we get not approved. That's our first IF function, so I wanted to keep it pretty straightforward for you. Let's add a little complexity to it now to show you some additional ways of getting the IF function to help you out. If we look at this total past due balance data here and say, if this value is 0, then we only want to return the current balance due. If this total past due balance is over 0, meaning that they have owed us some money for an unreasonable amount of time, we need to add a $25 service fee to everything that they owe us. We're now going to build this logic, sometimes called business logic, into our IF function. Let's go out here to the right end of our table and add a title to the first column and call it Total Balance Including Finance Charge. I'll copy the format of this cell into this new one using the format painter again, and then start off our IF function. equals, if, left parentheses. Our logical test that we want to start this all off with is to determine if this value in column G is greater than 0 or not. To do this, we just click on G3, and then the greater than sign, and then the number 0. If we remember our discussion on relational operators from the previous Lesson 4 videos, this function here will render a Boolean answer of either true or false. So this fits nicely here into the first parameter or argument of our if statement that demands a Boolean value. Now a comma, and for our value if true, we want to embed the logic that if this is true and there is a past due amount, then we want to add $25 to whatever they owe us. So we type in 25 plus the value in G3 plus the value in C3. Let me put a comma in here to get to the last part of the if statement now. If our logical argument is false and G3 is not greater than 0, then there is no past due balance, or we might actually owe them money. We don't want to ding them $25, so all we want this cell to display is their current balance. So we just place the value from the current balance, C3, here into the value if false part of our if statement. Close it up with the parentheses, hit enter, and there you go. Let's copy this formula down and test it out. We see here that if G3 is 0, then we want to show the current balance. Let's look at one of these that has a past due balance. Is this value of $495 greater than 0? That's true, so I'll add up C6 and G6, that's 495. And then if I mentally add $25 to that, we get 520. So it looks like it works. But you know how I like to test things, so let me copy this formula down one more row and play with some easily testable data for a minute. Let me put 0 for the current balance and 0 for our past due total here. Okay, we get 0. Let me put in a nice even 100 here, and we should get 125, because 100 plus 25 is 125. And we do. Let me change this current balance to 100 and test out that part of the formula, 225. So that all tests out great. In looking at this formula a bit, I want to introduce you to a new term here. See these formulas that are now built into our if function? Anytime you have formulas built into other formulas or functions, they're referred to as nested formulas. These formulas here in this if function are referred to as being nested into the if function. No huge big hairy deal here. You'll occasionally hear that term in this class, and I just wanted you to be able to understand it when I mention it, and then also be able to throw that term out in your casual conversations with friends in order to impress them. Let's improve on this formula a little bit. Notice that we placed that $25 fee here into our if function. What if that fee changes? We would have to go into each of these functions, and unless we're intimately familiar with every formula in this entire spreadsheet and might not know every nook and cranny where this mysterious $25 fee might be hidden or embedded into, I'm going to add a few rows up here into the top of our spreadsheet. And in this first row, I'll type in the text, data inputs. In the next row, I'll type in base penalty fee. In this cell, I'll put our $25 fee here and then name this cell base penalty fee, making sure to remember that we don't include spaces in our cell names. Now let's go back into our newest if function out here and double click on this ugly 25 hard coded here into the formula and type in the first few letters of our newly named cell. And once we have only one choice, we can just hit the tab key, then enter. Let's copy it down, and we're good to go. Now, if this fee changes, we can just change it up here in the data entry portion of the page, and all these formulas automatically update all of their answers. Let's apply the formatting to these cells below the first row to not have the redundant dollar signs cluttering up our page like we learned to in the first and second chapters. So we've now created some pretty simple as well as some pretty complicated if functions. See you in the next video.